In this short video, I'm going to go over some really important information regarding the email countdown image, especially if you're going to use it in multiple days. So if you're going to send out several emails over a span of the sequence, and you're going to use the email countdown image in multiple days, pay very close attention. Okay, so let's first cover how it would normally work in a perfect world. By the way, I'm going to present the challenge that we faced, and we've solved it, and then I'll show you the solution, but I want you to understand what the problem is first. So in a perfect world, your user would open up their email, and Gmail is a very popular email provider. So they, let's say on day one, they see 2 days and some hours left. Day two, you would expect they would see 1 day and some hours left. Day three, 0 days and 13 hours left. So day three in this example would be the final day. And that's accomplished by serving up the image every time that they open up their email. So on day two and day three, we're in an ideal world, if the image from the email is being pulled from the Deadline Funnel server, then they're going to see the correct time. And on day three, if the image is pulling from the Deadline Funnel server, they're going to see the correct time. However, a while ago, Google implemented something called image caching. And so it created a bit of a problem. And here's what that problem is. So with Google image caching, Google gets in the way of the image being pulled from our server. And so as you see here, day one, this isn't the perfect situation, but you see the red line, that's indicating, I'm trying to demonstrate that Google is not letting the image be pulled from our server. And so what you actually see is a situation where instead of the images being pulled from the server, Google is showing the image that the user saw on day one. So on day two and day three, they would be seeing the same image, not because there's a problem with our server or our technology, it's because Google is getting in the way. It's called Google image caching. And it was a real technical challenge for us to figure out how to get around, but we figured out how to get around it. Okay, before we dive in, I want to encourage you to open up a text document and to set up a space in your notes for each day. So in this example, I'm going to do just 3 days. And what's going to go in the notes are things like the expiring links, but specific to this video, the code or the URL for the email countdown image. And this just helps keep you organized. And you'll see why this is important in just a bit. Now, one last thing I want to say is that some tools like Word or WordPad should not be used. You want to use something that is a true text editor and does not change quotes or anything about the URL. Editors like Word and WordPad, they do things to quotes and they just modify it. And what that does is that actually breaks the HTML code. So you just want to stay away from those. All right, so let's go ahead and dive in. So inside of the Deadline Funnel admin, under the Use It, go to the Use It section on the left, under the Email Setup tab, we've got the HTML image code and also the image URL. Which one you used will be covered in the Quick Start Guide. So just reference your Quick Start Guide based on which email service provider you're using. So in this example, I'm just going to be using the image URL. All right. So what you need to do is every single time that you are going to be sending out the email countdown image for a particular day, you want to click copy. And when you copy that, it will be copied to your clipboard and you go and you paste it in. Everything seems normal so far, right? Well, now what you want to do is you want to click copy again. So in other words, you don't want to just go ahead and paste it in twice and just consider it done. Notice how this bit on the end is the same for day two and day three, but it's different for day one. That's because I clicked the copy button again. So for each day, click copy. It's just real simple. And every single time, our system will automatically generate a little bit of random information on the end of the URL. Now, this bit of information on the end of the URL is not the entire solution to getting around Google's Gmail caching, but the rest of it you don't need to know about because it's done on our server. So the critical thing to know is that for every single day that you're going to be sending out an email, with the email countdown image, you want to come over here and click copy and then paste it in. So copy and then paste, copy and then paste. Don't copy, paste, paste, paste. go in here, click the copy button, and every single time you click copy, it will generate a new URL for you to use. And so then you'll go into your email software and you'll just plug and play. So for day one, you'll just grab this code and put that in there. For day two, you'll grab this code and put it in there, etc. And then the last thing that I'll mention, since you're watching this video, is that when you're testing, because a lot of times you're opening up an email that you had already sent yourself, so you might open it up and then send it to yourself again the same day, like a few minutes later, because you're going through tests, it's very possible that you're still seeing a cached image. To keep in mind that your subscribers are gonna be, they're not gonna be reopening the same email over and over and over again. They're gonna open up day one email, read it, and then do something. Day two email, read it, and hopefully do something. But for your testing purposes, if you're seeing the same image and you think, well, maybe it's not working, just hit refresh on your Gmail tab. Just hit refresh and Gmail will load back up again. You may need to open that image, that email back up, and you should see the correct countdown time. At least that's what we're seeing in our tests. So I hope this gives you the how, what, and why of setting up the animated countdown images in your emails when you're going to send them out, not just once in your sequence, but over multiple days.